نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد رسوله النبي الأمين المكين الحنين الكريم الرؤوف الرحيم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم وَإِن تُطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَا يَلِتْكُم مِّنْ أَعْمَالِكُمْ شَيْئًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ صدق الله مولانا العظيم. This is the verse number 14 from Surah Al-Hujurat. Again, the subject of this verse is Iman. The subject of the verse is reality of Iman. In our last episode and last talk, we gave the idea, general idea of Iman regarding from the same surah. But now we want to elaborate it through its meanings and implications. Almighty Allah says, the desert Arabs say, we believe, amanna, we have brought Iman. Qul lam tu'minu, say you have no faith, you have not brought Iman. Walakin qulu aslamna, but you should say only that we have submitted. We have embraced Islam, but you have embraced Islam, but you have not still become the believers in real sense. So here there is a differentiation between Iman and Islam. Here the word Islam has been used in the sense of embracing the deen of Islam. And the word Iman has been used as a condition. وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. But still for faith and Iman has not still entered your hearts. But if you obey Allah and His Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which means then you will get the condition of Iman, and your amal and your good deeds will also not be harmed. So here the basic thing which has been explained is the elaboration of the concept of Iman. First of all, we will deal with it in the sense that what is the meaning of Iman, etymological meanings, and then literal meanings, and then its implication. Literal and etymological meanings of Iman are that the word Iman has been derived from its root cause. Its root is amana. It means aman means safety and security, and Iman has two meanings regarding amn. One is its meaning, what's meaning of amn? First meaning is to get the safety and to enter into safety and to get security, to be secure. And the second meaning of Iman is to provide security and to provide safety. So mu'min has twofold characters. Mu'min is a man who gets into the condition of safety and security, and mu'min is a man who provides safety and security to others. So we will try to understand both of the meanings through Quran. For example, it is narrated in Holy Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 239. فَإِذَا أَمِنْتُمْ فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَمَا عَلَّمَكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ. When you get the safety and security and satisfaction, amintum, when you get safety and security, then remember Almighty God and remember your Lord as He has informed you and as He has educated you. Here the word amintum means when you get the condition of security and satisfaction. And in Suratul Quraysh it is stated, Allazi at'amahum min ju'in wa amanahum min khawf Lord is He who provided the food during hunger and provided the safety and security during fear and terror. So here is the concept of provision and of safety, and there was the concept of getting the safety. So mu'min has twofold character. As far as the mu'min is concerned, it has twofold character of iman. The first character is of mu'min is that through iman he gets into security, he gets into safety. What kind of safety? He becomes safe of hell, he becomes safe of violation of the commandment of Allah, he becomes safe from deviation towards harmful way of life. He comes into safety, safety of rahmah, safety of obedience, safety of submission, safety of good faith. So iman becomes his safety provider. And the second character of iman is, this concept is iman mutaaddi ila al-ghair. In this concept, the man who has faith, he becomes the provider of faith to others. It is mentioned in Holy, as it is mentioned in Holy Quran, wal mu'minun wal mu'minat ba'duhum awliya'u ba'd. The believer men and believer women, they are the helpers and supporters of one another. So to be helper and supporter of one another is to be the provider of safety to one another. So here the mu'min is a man who provides safety to other, who provides security to other. And same idea has been elaborated in prophetic hadith. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wallahi la yu'min, wallahi la yu'min, wallahi la yu'min. Qila man ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qala alladhi la ya'manu jarahu bawa'iquh. Holy Prophet said, by God, he is not a mu'min. By God, he is not the believer. By God, he is not the believer. He was asked, who? O Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the man who does not provide the security and safety to his neighbor, the man whose neighbor does not get safety and security from a man, he cannot claim to be a believer. So to become a believer, it is necessity that he should be the provider of safety to his neighbor. So here is the idea. The same idea has been mentioned in Holy Quran. So there are two aspects, conceptual iman and practical iman. Iman in theory and iman in practice. Iman in theory is to have ikrarum bil lisan wa tasdeekum bil qalb. We should have faith in existence of Allah, faith in the prophets and messengers of Allah, faith in divinely revealed books, faith in the angels, faith in the day of judgment, and faith in resurrection. These beliefs should be declared and uttered, declared through mouth in the form of utterance and speech, and these should be declared through heart in the form of cordial certification. This is iman and faith in theory. And faith in practice is as stated in Holy Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. This, up to this extent, this was iman in theory. And now iman, ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. Only those are believers and mu'mineen who have believed in Allah and His Messenger and have never since doubted. Up to this extent, this is iman in theory. Now iman in practice. وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. And believers are those who strive with their belongings and properties and amwal and with their persons and lives in cause of Allah, in the way of Allah. Such are the sincere ones. What is meant by sincere one? Such are the sincere mu'mineen, sincere believers. So iman in theory was to have a faith in existence of unseen realities without any shadow of doubt. And iman in practice is to become a man of that kind which is required and which is on which Almighty Allah is pleased. So to men, to put Iman in his practice, to become the provider of safety for the whole mankind. If a man, moment has to become the provider of security to his neighbor, so every moment has a specific neighborhood. So it means the society of Ahlul Iman is a society which provides indiscriminately the safety and security to all of the people. Whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims, they should be provided the safety. They should be provided the security. This is the only basic requirement of Iman. So if the moment become, that's why Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Al-mu'minu lil-mu'mini kal-bunyan yashuddu ba'dahu ba'dan. A mu'min is bunyan for other mu'min. He is the safety provider for other mu'min. Is the supporter and helper for other mu'min. And it is again stated by Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Masalul mu'minina fi tawaddihim wa tarahumihim wa ta'atufihim Masalul jasad izashtaka minhu udwun tada'a lahu sa'irul jasad bis-sahri wal humma. So this is the concept of Iman in practice. We pray to Almighty God that He should grant us with Iman in both characters, in practice, in our theories and in our practice, so that we may change our life in accordance with the requirements of Islam and Iman. Wama alayna illa al-balagh.